dreamer. Come on. Oh.
He's one of the brightest kids in his class, Daniel. He's flunking 3 subjects. You can't reward him with a party.
You only have your 12th birthday once, Miranda.
Yes, you're right. It's a special occasion. Forget about the grades. Let's just concentrate on trashing the house.
I told you I'd clean it up.
Oh, sure you will, in some alternate universe. I'm sure somewhere there's another you that actually helps out around the house.
The kids, they attract dirt, that's all.
Dirt? We live in an archaeological excavation site. Entire civilizations under beds, behind dressers, towels, wet ones fermenting on the ground, archives of junk mail. Your car, Daniel, your car. I bought it for you 2 years ago. It's an embarrassment.
It's a car, Miranda.
Oh, it's a health hazard. I found a little pile of food on the foot of your closet.
I was trying to show Natty how penicillin grows. You didn't throw that out, did you? Gloria, do you have something you'd like to share with the class?
I was just cleaning up after those horrid animals.
You know, if this conversation involved you, we'd be looking more at you.
It's not like you're busy. You have lots more free time than I do, even when you are working. Yeah, it's all right. I already know. I tried to call you at the studio today. Lou told me what happened. Why, Daniel? Why can't you just do your job?
I was doing my job. My job is to be Pudgy the Parrot. And Pudgy the Parrot doesn't poison the minds of young America with cheery thoughts of nicotine and lung cancer. It's not in his character.
Actors.
What? Actors? I have a responsibility to those kids.
Responsibility? Did you say responsibility? What about the responsibility you have to our children, to this house, to our bank account?
I'm sorry I don't bring in as much as you.
This is just too much. I can't live this way anymore. The kids can't live this way.
What way? You don't know squat how the kids live. You either come home too late or too goddamn tired to even be with them.
Excuse me if I happen to be the only steady breadwinner in this family we've been married. Excuse me if I happen to work hard. Excuse me if every once in a while I get home late to this pigsty you call a home.
Oh, give me a break. Gloria, why don't you go get your minicam so you can come in for a real tight shot, okay, dear?
I'm concerned for Mrs. Hillard's well-being. I've read about people like you. You're a demented man. You're potentially dangerous. I've heard you talking with your children, using different voices. You're a multiple personality.
Multiple personalities. Let me finish.
Should one of those personalities attempt to do physical harm to Mrs. Hillard, I'll be ready.
Is that mace, Gloria? Come on, spray me. I was in Berkeley in the 60s. Give it your best shot, Gloria.
Thank you.
You call me if you need me, Mrs. Hillard.
Thank you, Gloria. Thank you for caring.
Let her spray me. I'll sue her, sweat her off.
For goodness sake, get aggressive with the little old lady next door.
She's not the little lady. That's Jakub, Hoover, and Drag.
I have a lot of patience with children, but if they get uppity, here's what I do. I mix a little lemonade with a lot of bourbon, and they just drop like sheep on a summer day. How's that? Back to the drawing board, Bubba.
So, Scarecrow, how about a little fire, huh? So, where are you from? A big stack of hay? You got a needle in there somewhere?
Ooh, this is scary to me. It would scare the hell out of kids.
No, but don't get discouraged. It's a work in progress. You're my brother. I'm not going to let you look foolish.
All right.
I think we're going to have to do the entire face.
Beautiful garden, dear.
Oh, thank you very much.
Backbiting bitch.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Hello. You must be the new maid, euthanasia dumbwaiter.
No, dear. It's Ephigenia Doubtfire, and I'm the housekeeper.
Oh, the housekeeper, yes.
And you are?
Gloria Cheney. I live next door.
Oh, Mrs. Cheney. Lovely to meet you.
Cheney.
Cheney. Oh, you're that busy woman who lives next door. Mrs. Hillard spoke so highly of you. And you were a great deal of help with the problems with her ex.
He's a monster.
Why?
Everyone knows that he cheated on his wife.
Really?
I've heard that he beat her, and I know that he slapped the children around.
I never did that.
I beg your pardon?
I never heard that he did that. She never alluded to that. You'll have to go through me.
Well, I'm very glad to hear that. Of course, she never would have said anything about it. It conjures up awful memories. I hope that you won't mention any of the things that I just said to you to Mrs. Hillard. It might send her into deep depression.
I completely understand, dear. This is a one-way street. You have a confidant in me.
Well, I can see that we have a lot in common.
Besides our green thumbs.
Oh, you're a flower lover. Would you like to see my babies?
I would love to caress your bulbs. I love to stick my fingers in the warm, moist dirt.
Oh, isn't it wonderful?
And feel a hot bulb. It's so lovely, that.
Yes, here, I've worked on these for years.
Oh, what cuties. Yes, they're exquisite. Yes. Oh, look at that one there.
You're a gardener, are you?
Dear, I was a horticultural supervisor for Reginald Flaxwater III.
Oh.
The Duke of Fairfax.
A duke?
Yes,
really?
Dear. Oh, he had a stunning garden. It was like a Monet canvas springing to life.
Oh.
Yes, but you know the one thing, dear? Yours are just as beautiful, except your stems are flaccid and flabby.
What?
Yes, dear. Look at these stems, dear.
No.
Look at this. Here's a good stiff stem with a bud about to erupt.
What?
There's a simple formula for all of this.
Well, what is the formula? What is the formula for my flowers?
Oh, dear, it's a Doubtfire family secret. I can't divulge it.
Oh, please, I won't tell a soul.
Oh, dear.
Please.
You're in need, dear. You swear?
Yes, I swear.
All right, dear, because you're in need and your stems are flabby, I'll tell you. Here it is. It's so simple, it will amaze you.
Uh-huh.
First ingredient, 2 liters of English breakfast tea.
English breakfast tea, yes.
Next, 1 tablespoon brewed coffee grounds.
Coffee grounds, one tablespoon.
Brewed. That's it, dear. And here's the key to the whole formula.
Yes.
This is what makes the whole thing sing.
Yes.
A splash of winkle.
Winkle?
Yes, dear. Tea.
Pee-pee.
Tea. Piss, dear.
Oh.
Urine.
Mine?
No.
Oh, heavens, no.
Dog urine. Puppy pizzle.
Dog urine?
Yes,
on my babies?
Oh. What do you think fertilizer is? It's horse pucky. Feces, dear. Poop. Shite. That's what it is, dear. You've been putting caca on your ranunculus for years. What's a wee pee on your posies, dear? You see, combined with the other 2 ingredients, it makes a very formidable fertilizer. Hair of the dog, to say the least.
But I'm to put this mixture on my flowers every day?
3 times a day, dear.
Yes.
3 times a day for optimum effect. A little puppy spritzer, that's what you do.
But how do I go about getting dog urine?
I usually found that the male dogs are better than the females, because when you see that leg go up, you get under there with a little Dixie cup. With a female, you'd have to use a saucer. It's difficult, you know? And don't try and substitute any cats. No pussy pee-pee. No, dear.
Yes.
And then your babies will be blossoming with the morning dew, as it were.
Well, I certainly don't want my stems to be flaccid.
Oh, no, dear. We all need a good stiff stem.
Yes, I know I do.
I know you do.
Oh, yes, well.
It's our little secret now. Chrysanthemum's the word.
Chrysanthemum's the word.
That's it, dear. Good luck to you.
Thank you very much. I appreciate your help.
Yes. Oh, here I'll comes one now, dear. Good luck.
Good. Thank you. I'll see you again.
I hope not.
Hey, you guys smell cookies?
Cookies.
Bonjour, mes enfants. Voulez-vous un petit goûter? It's welcome home, kids. How about a snack, eh? Mademoiselle Lydie.
I'm not hungry.
Oh.
Girlfriend's got to chill. Sister dissed my cookies. Well, we are going to party in the kitchen. Yo, yo, yo.
Let's get busy in the kitchen then.
All right. One more for extra measure.
Daniel?
Mr. Hillard, you give me that phone this instant.
You don't live here anymore. Now get out of here.
The nerve of you. Hello?
Mrs. Doubtfire, what's Daniel doing there?
Oh, Mrs. Hillard. He said he came by to drop something off, but I don't believe him for one instant.
I think he's just snooping around, you know, dear. I didn't know it possessed him to answer the phone. Hold on, Mrs. Hillard. Mrs. Hillard does not want you here.
Now, are you going to go, or am I going to have to call the police?
I'm going. I'm sorry.
You should be. Now, get out of here, you poor sad bastard. He's gone.
Thank you very much. I'm so glad you're there.
Oh, that's all right, dear. You no more than me.
Listen, I'm going to be a little late getting home tonight.
Really?
I should be there about 8 o'clock or so. Would you mind starting dinner for me?
Oh, yes, dear. Don't worry about the thing. Okay. That's all right, dear. Really, don't worry about one moment. Everything's going to be fine, dear.
Okay.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
What do you think?
Oh, suit. It's nice.
I'm getting good at this. I can become a woman in less than 5 minutes.
That's great. Took my friend Jimmy 10 years. And the shots.
Ouch.
Babies are a bit brown. You've gone from a Claude Monet to an Edvard Munch. Did you follow my instructions?
Yes. 2 liters English breakfast tea.
Yes.
A tablespoon of coffee grounds.
Brewed.
Brewed.
And the dog urine.
A splash.
Oh, that's it, dear.
What?
It's his bad teeth. It's a dash.
A dash?
Yes, dear.
A dash is different from a splash?
Yes, dear. Just like a grab is more than a pinch.
Ow.
See, a dash equals 3 splashes.
Oh.
So correct the formula immediately and increase the application to 5 times a day, all right?
5.
5 times a day, oh. Dear. That will do it.
Oh,
I'm very sorry about the bad teeth.
Oh, my babies. Oh, babies. Poor little girls.
What a beautiful little car for Don Juan. Oh, sad when that happens.
As far as the court is concerned.
Yes, I understand. I totally agree with you. And I'm very happy that you found everything here.
It is absolutely lovely, Miss Hillard.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
I'll let you know the next time that I need to stop by.
Thank you.
So nice.
We'll be right back.
actually really cool.
I don't care, you look like an idiot.
Don't do that. Why not? I mean, this is the cool thing. Everybody's doing this right now.
Girls don't like that stuff.
Oh, really? Well, guys do, okay?
Well, who do you want to dance with, guys or girls?
Hey, wait, whoa, what's happening?
What are you guys doing?
We were trying to practice for the spring dance. At least I was.
Well, he's not helping. He's doing all these stupid moves, and he's not listening to me.
Well, I can help. Why don't you dance with me?
No, no, it's okay.
We're fine, thanks.
First of all, we need some music. No offense, but let's put some better music on.
Oh, no. She's going for the records.
She can't dance.
I heard that. Of course I can dance. I wasn't always a nag. I used to dance. Get ready to rock out. Here it comes. I love this part. I love this part.
The word is antithesis. Antithesis.
Antithesis. A-N-T-I-T-H-E-S-S-I-S. Antithesis.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. Andrew Bates. The word is necessary. Necessary.
Necessary. N-E-C-E. S S A R Y.
That is correct. The word is albatross. Albatross.
Albatross. A L B T R.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. Lydia Hillard. The word is venerable. Venerable.
Venerable. V-E-N-E-R-A-B-L-E.
Where's my seat?
We tried to save you a seat.
Here, write another excuse to keep me away from the kids, huh?
Daddy, we tried to save you a seat, but this lady took it.
Excuse me. Could you move? I'd like to see my family.
Would you please be quiet?
Daniel, for goodness sake.
What?
D-E-N-C-E.
Correct.
You're late.
No, the word is discriminate. Discriminate.
No,
Daniel. Shh.
I've lowered my voice.
Okay? Sorry.
You're late. If you'd gotten here on time, you would have a seat.
Hey, guys, you're messing up Lydia.
Discriminate. D-I-S-C-R-I-M-A-T-E.
I'm sorry. That is incorrect. Mecca, Washington. Thank you.
Lydia?
Go talk to
her. Sorry. I couldn't control myself. Sorry, Blue.
Why can't you just pretend?
To be what, honey?
Pretend to be Mrs. Doubtfire and pretend to be Pudgy the bird and all those other things. Why can't you and Mom just pretend to be happy?
We probably could.
And we'd still be a family.
Yeah, we would be. But we'd be a pretend family, you know? It wouldn't be real. You'd know. You know, we'd be acting. You can't act 24 hours a day. I'm not that good an actor. Today proved that. You know? Life's more real and wonderful than that. Acting? It's nice, but it's a job.
It's your job to be our father.
No, it's not a job. It's a joy being your father. I don't have to play the part of your father. I am your father. I may act like a fool, but I am your father, okay? Always. Rain, shine. That's the one wonderful thing in my life. You forgive me?
Evening, my lady.
Evening.
Now, this one's on me. Now, I insist.
Me too.
Yeah, I've been driving this bus on and off for almost 20 years now. I've been thinking about retiring lately.
Well, it might be time.
Don't know what I'd do with my time if I retired.
Well, a cruise would be nice.
Well, you know, I get Thursday nights off. Would you like to go to the VFW dance? We could make beautiful music together.
Oh, dear. I'm afraid we'd be playing the same note.
Huh?
In terms of plumbing, we have the same pipes below the water line.
I don't get it.
I'm a guy.
A guy?
Yes, dear.
Wow. You could have fooled me. You really do a wonderful job. Is it your profession?
No, amateur. I'm kind of a self-made woman.
Oh, I'd give you a first prize any night you wanted to have a contest. I think you're, well, I still think you're beautiful, you know. What can I tell you?
Thank you.
Well, the best of luck to you, and hang in there.
I am.
Mrs. Doubtfire?
Yes.
Is everything all right?
Oh, fine, dear. It's just these godforsaken corsets.
Do you need some help?
Oh, no, dear. It's just with my figure, it takes a little more time.
All right.
All right. I'll be out in a minute.
Here we go. Everything okay?
She'll be out in a minute.
Oh, good. Let's find the waiter, shall we?
Good.
Found and lost.
We have a lost and found, sir.
Close enough. My mom was feeling a little underdressed for such an elegant restaurant, and she was changing in the ladies' room, and I believe she left her things. Could you check for me? Thank you.
Are these what you want?
Who wouldn't?
Daddy! Mommy, Daddy's here.
No, he's not.
Well, he was a second ago.
Maybe it's just someone who looked like him.
Someone who looked a lot like him.
No, it wasn't him. We have to feed her. She's starting to hallucinate.
Fantine Devereaux, Cher, from the Maison Etouffee. Here to do a spot check on your Cajun cuisine.
Of the Maison Etouffee?
Is this your jambalaya?
Yes, ma'am.
Hold on, let me just give a quick take here. Oh, that's the blandest baby food. That's not jambalaya, that's styrofoam.
Well, it was a special request.
Oh, honey, then you can't call it Cajun, because it ain't Cajun unless you're ready to kiss the devil on the lip. So we're going to give a little bit of devil lip there. You know, you don't get in the jacuzzi unless you like it hot. That's what we want here.
That water's gonna be boiling.
You up the Cajun cuisine standard. Now get on back there and blacken that fish. Merci beaucoup. Let it bon food roll there, eh?
Do I look like a goddamn gardener to you?
What kind of father dresses like a woman?
What kind of mother puts dog piss on her babies?
Oh, you...
Get inside, or I'll show you what's under the skirt.
Oh, you, Daniel! Hillard, you're a devil! You're a devil! You're a devil!
The flowers, oh, get a light.
Yes! Oh! No! Oh! No!
We need to talk.
I can't talk to you dressed like that.
I'll change. May I come in? Thanks. Listen, I'm sorry, but you gotta understand something, okay? Listen to me,
you
please.
You sat there while I served you tea. Yeah. You encouraged me to talk openly about our marriage. You took money to sneak around this house uninvited.
The money always came back, didn't it? It was a job that needed to be done because you sure as hell didn't do it very well. And I did it great. And you told me 100 times as Mrs. Doubtfire I was wonderful. And I would have done it as myself for nothing, but you wouldn't let me do it.
There are no excuses. I cannot forgive you ever.
I did it because I just wanted to be with the kids.
You lied to the kids.
I never lied to the kids, okay?
What do you mean?
They found out.
They knew?
Yes.
How dare you?
Oh, don't.
How dare you encourage them to deceive me?
Don't you get it? You're the reason for the whole deceit. Because you're trying to throw away years of being together. You're just trying to erase it like it doesn't exist. You're trying to destroy the fact that we're a family.
This family doesn't work.
Oh, it works if you let it work.
It's more harmful for them to be in this family than it is for them to be in a divorce family. That they can adjust to.
No, they can't adjust to that. I'm their father. They love me.
I'm their mother. They love me.
I hate you both.
Please leave, Daniel.